In this tutorial, we'll show you how to use the scaling and measuring tools in Netfabb Basic. Bring your file into Netfabb Basic by going to Project, Add Part. When you open your 3D model for the first time, tumble around the view to take a look at it in all three dimensions. If you downloaded this model from the internet, like we did with this deer skull, chances are this is the first time you've seen the model in three dimensions. Pay attention to the 3D axis guide in the bottom left-hand corner. Netfabb also provides you with orthographic views of your model. To rescale or resize your model, go to Part, Scale. I mentioned earlier to pay attention to the 3D axis guide in the bottom left-hand corner. That's because you'll notice, on the main screen, the size of your model is expressed as length, width, and height. However, in the rescale screen, the size of your model is expressed in terms of X, Y, and Z. If you're confused as to which axis refers to the length, width, or height, look at the 3D axis guide for reference. In this case, I want to scale down the longest dimension, 10 inches, down to 5. And I'll click Scale and Close. Now you'll see the new size, again expressed as length, width, and height in the main screen. If you're dropping off files to be printed at FIT's FabLab, our uPrint Plus printers have a platform size of 8 inches by 8 inches by 6 inches, so all models must fit within this area. Now we're going to show you some measuring tools built into Netfabb. You want to go to Extras, New Measuring, and you'll be in Measuring View. Netfabb has a handful of measuring tools, the most useful of which is the Wall Thickness tool. The Wall Thickness tool acts as a digital caliper, and anywhere you click on your model, it will tell you exactly how thick it is at that point. As you can see, the tip of this antler is 0.12 inches across. If you're dropping off for 3D printing with FIT's FabLab, our printer has a minimum wall size of 0.035 inches. Features or walls smaller than this will still print, but they may be very unstable and fragile. A more fragile example would be the orbital bone of the skull. This is very close to the minimum capabilities of our printer, so this area of this model may be fragile when printed. Another measuring tool is called the PointtoPoint Tool, which allows you to click on any two points of your model, and it gives you the distance between. As you can see here, the distance from the back of the skull to the front of the skull, minus the antlers, is 3.54 inches. This can be useful if you need to measure parts of your model, but you don't want to break them into pieces. When you're satisfied with the rescaling and the measuring you've done, you can export your part by going to Part, Export Part, Export as STL. We recommend giving it a descriptive name, such as Scaled 5 inches, so that you know how you've altered your model. For more information about the FabLab, please visit fitnyc.edu/printfx. And to obtain a free copy of Netfabb Basic, go to netfabb.com.